Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology, Angus here with the National Weather Forecast for Friday the 15th of November. And the key talking points this week have been stormy afternoons and very hot weather. And Friday is pretty much par for the course on both of those, with more storms expected through parts of the east and north, more areas getting some very hot conditions. But we get one extra piece to the puzzle on Friday. That's this cold front down here that we see working up from the southwest. Now during the day on Friday, it doesn't have a huge impact on our weather. It will bring some slightly cooler conditions to southern parts of Western Australia, but this is one to note because it's going to have a big part to play in the forecast across the southeast throughout the course of the weekend. Let's get down to Friday's detail now, starting as usual in Queensland. And another day, another storm outbreak for Queensland. Pretty widespread storms again, focusing on the southeast of the state. We are looking at areas from the Capricornia down to the south coast, including the Wide Bay, pushing inland to the scenic rim, the Eastern Downs and up into the Burnett area, as well as parts of the Central Highlands, for being the focus of storms on Friday afternoon. The possibility of severe storms exists through this region during the afternoon and evening hours as well, where we could see some heavy rain, large hail or damaging wind gusts. If you're north of Rockhampton on the east coast, it's a fine and another warm day. Heatwave conditions, in fact, across the tropical north. We may see some further storms around Gulf Country, and it's fine for the rest of inland Queensland. A few showers on Friday for the New South Wales coast. If you're in Sydney or Newcastle or south of that, the showers pretty light, pretty sparse and spread apart. Plenty of dry weather in the mix for the southern coast, but the wet weather a touch more persistent for the northeast of the state. And from Coffs Harbour northwards, maybe even a thunderstorm or two, but at this stage, severe thunderstorms look unlikely. Friday brings another clear, settled day for everyone west of the Great Dividing Range. And a mild, settled day on Friday across Victoria. A little bit of cloud cover in the south, particularly through the morning and again in the evening, but primarily a bright and sunny afternoon across the state. Temperatures pretty much in line with average for this time of year, but it will be getting a whole lot warmer than that the following day as we move into the weekend. A few showers around northeastern Tasmania during Friday, not having much of an impact, maybe just clipping a few centres here and there. Elsewhere, generally quite settled. Cool to mild temperatures though across Tasmania for Friday, and partly to mostly cloudy skies for much of the state as well. But do bear through the cooler temperatures because it is getting a lot warmer in the weekend. In fact, as much as 10 degrees warmer on Saturday compared to Friday. And the yo-yoing temperatures we've seen in recent weeks across South Australia takes another upward swing on Friday as the winds tend round to the north. That is going to push most of the state either to the upper 20s or into the 30s. So it's a warm, sunny day statewide on Friday. It will be getting quite windy though, those winds really picking up after lunch and staying fairly strong into the start of the weekend. Cooler air arrives in southern Western Australia through the course of the day, so temperatures a touch cooler than where they've been. Perth is about 5 degrees cooler than the last few days. It will be a little wet along the very south coast, but dry from Bunbury right up to the northwest. The storm risk for inland Western Australia does continue, covering much of the interior of the state, actually pushing down towards the Eucla coastline as well. And take a look at this, Eucla 40 degrees, so a very hot day with the chance of an afternoon or evening storm there. And the storms could bring damaging wind gusts to inland areas. And across the north, maybe an early shower or storm for the top end. Then most of the day is dry in the territory, but we will see afternoon showers redevelop through the Carpentaria and Gregory districts, maybe pushing up into the southern top end. Parts of the Kimberley could have showers or storms at any stage of day, with some locally moderate falls. All the latest weather information and any weather warnings always available on the Bureau website and app. Thanks for checking in and have a great day.